Hello and welcome to this presentation about the Smith College in Florence, Italy program. My name is Maria Succi Hempster and I teach in the Italian Studies Department at Smith College, and I am also the liaison between the department and the program in Florence. We will start talking about the options and the requirements you'll need to fulfill in order to participate. If you would like to participate to this program, you have three options. The first option is that of participating for one semester only, either in the fall or in the spring semester, or for the entire academic year. For all three options, you will have to take certain courses, and these are courses that are the equivalent of 2 years of Italian, or the equivalent of college level Italian, which is normally for 4 credit courses. So if you started taking Italian with us at Smith College, probably you took or you're going to take Italian 110, which is the elementary level course, and that lasts one entire academic year, or Italian 111, which is the accelerated course, and that is the equivalent of 2 semesters. Once you complete Italian 110 or 111, you will take Italian 220, which is the intermediate level language course. At that point, you have one more course to take, and you'll have the choice to take 245 or 250. So if you think of going to Florence in the fall or for the entire academic year, you will have to take 250 in the semester before your departure, because there is a requirement. You are required to take an Italian course in the semester right before your departure. So if you go in the fall, that course will be Italian 250, offered the previous spring. If instead you are going to Florence in the spring semester, you will take Italian 245, which is offered every fall semester here on campus. That said, we recommend that you take both, because that way you will be more prepared to for academic life in Florence. We also highly recommend that you take Italian 235, which is a conversation course. It's a 2-credit course and it's offered almost every semester on campus, and it can be repeated 2 times. Once you arrive in Florence, every student will take a brief orientation. It's a 2-week orientation. And during this time, students will take an intensive language course at the Smith Center, which we call La Sede, as well as an art history course that focuses on medieval and Renaissance art in and around Florence. In addition to this academic orientation, which will give you 2 credits, students will be divided in small groups and will be taken around the city to explore the city, to get introduced to the transportation system, the parks, the shops, the markets, the libraries, all the cool places where Italian students gather and eat and drink and listen to music and watch shows and so on. Once you complete your orientation, the semester starts. During the semester, every student is required to take a course which is called Italian 240, and it's an advanced language course. The other requirement is that you will have to take at least 1 course at the University of Florence. So each semester, students are permitted to take up to 3 courses at the sede in total, and the remaining courses will be taken at the University of Florence. Tutoring will be provided as necessary throughout the year. These are the courses that are available each fall at the sede. One is an art history course, and another course is Italian social and cultural history. And then there will also be a new course that is not offered right now, but will be next year. It's an experientially based course that will be offered next year, both in the fall and in the spring semester. This is a list of departments at the University of Florence where our students can take courses. As you can see, you can take courses pretty much at almost all departments. Of course, you can take courses in all the humanities, but also in the Department of Agriculture, Economics, Engineering, Education, Math, Physical, Natural Sciences, Political Science, Architecture, and others. In the spring semester, the requirements are the same. First of all, students who arrive in the spring will again take part in an orientation, not again, because students who are there for a year will only take part in the orientation in the fall. But students who arrive in the spring will take part in the orientation for about 2 weeks, and also in that language, advanced language course that I was telling you about. Students who are there since the fall, instead of this course, will be taking some other course offered at the Sede or the Smith Center. The courses offered at Smith Center in the spring are different from the fall. So there will be, again, a art history course, but not the same. This one is called a Factory of Genius, Workshops and Painters at the Time of Lorenzo il Magnifico. There will be a History of Fashion and Costume course, and there will be a course called Italian 251, Words Beyond the Page. And again, like I was mentioning before, there will be a new experientially based course also offered in the spring. Something I haven't said yet that is very important is that all the courses that you will be taking at the University of Florence have to be first approved by the academic director in Florence, and if necessary, also by your director or by your advisor on campus. This is a list of courses that just a selection of courses that are offered both in Italian and English in the government department. I was given this list by the directors in Florence because we've had quite a few students who are majors in government or at Smith, and so they wanted to show us, to show you, the variety of courses that can be taken there. So let's talk a little bit about life in Florence. These are some of the pictures that I took when I was there shortly before the pandemic started. As you can see, the Sede, the Smith Center, is really beautiful. It is on the third floor of a beautiful historic building. The rooms are very spacious. They have high ceilings and beautiful floors and beautiful details. The one on the left is a classroom, a big classroom. The one in the center is the office of our residential director. The picture on the right is of the library. These are more pictures. You see the computer room. There's another classroom. There's a little sitting area of one of the classrooms. And finally, another smaller room that is used for seminars or to study. Students who participate in this program have the option to live with Florentine families or to live in apartments. If you choose to live with a family, all families are situated within the city, you will be living with the Italian family, and this way you'll be able to learn a lot about Italian culture, and you will make significant progress in speaking Italian. Many students say that this is the highlight of their experience in Florence. If life with a family is not for you, you have the opportunity to live in an apartment where you will be in a single or in a double room, and you will share the bathroom with and all the common spaces in the kitchen with other students, with other Smith students. you will have a lot of opportunities to connect with local students in libraries, coffee shops, and cafeterias, and the staff in Florence will be very happy to assist you and direct you. If you live with a family or in an apartment, you will receive a stipend. If you live with a family, you will typically eat breakfast at home, and you will eat a dinner which is cooked by the host family. The program will provide a monthly allowance to cover the cost of buying lunch. Students who live in a shared apartment will also receive a stipend, and that stipend will cover the expenses for food, but they will cook the food themselves in the kitchen that they share with their housemates. Students participate in a lot of activities. I have some pictures that I have received from Florence, and this list of activities is just what they have been doing since this group that is there right now has done in less than 2 months. In general, the students and the staff in Florence are reporting that everything feels safe. Everybody's following protocols. The protocols for students there are very similar to what we have here on campus. Everybody has been vaccinated. They test regularly. In Italy, everybody's back to work. Students are back in school. And for every indoor activity, the general population is required, including our students, of course, are required to show proof of vaccination, what they call the green pass, or of a recent COVID test. And this system has allowed the reopening of museums and theaters, restaurants. And so as a result, our students as well have been participating in a lot of activities and outings. And as I was saying, this is a list of the things that they've been doing just in the last couple of months. So here you have pictures of a restoration workshop they also visited a rooftop garden on top of Palazzo Pucci. That's the third picture down. They also did food tastings, aperitivi, pottery workshops, creative recycling workshops, cooking classes, and they just went to see a match of the local soccer team, Fiorentina. Students can participate in these outings as a group or sometimes individually. They will go to theater, exhibitions, conferences, and so on. These are some pictures of a day trip that they took together as a group. They went to Ravenna, and Ravenna was the western seat of the Roman Empire, and they got to see these beautiful mosaics, and they also paid homage to the tomb of Dante Alighieri. That's the picture at the bottom right. So if you have any questions, please come see me. My office is in Hatfield Hall, or you can email me. That's my email address. Or if you have questions about courses in Florence or life in Florence, you can also contact directly our directors there, our academic coordinator, Professor Guido Reverdito, and our resident administrative director, Monica Ginanneschi. Before I end this presentation, I'm going to show you a short video, two short videos. One is a saluto from Monica, the resident administrative director. When we had the presentation on campus, Monica wasn't able to attend because it was on a day that is a national holiday in Italy. So she sent this video message for you. And right after that, I'm going to play a short slideshow made for you by one of the students who is in Florence right now. So I say ciao now, arrivederci, and I hope to hear from you very soon. Bye bye.
Ciao, sono Monica. I am the director of the program in Florence, the administrative director. And I'm doing this video because unfortunately I will not be able to join Maria and Giovanna in the presentation on Monday because it's a holiday in Italy and I will be traveling that day at that time. So I'm sending you a short video because I want to tell you that I would be happy to have you in Florence. And I also want to tell you that now the students are doing many things, even in the pandemic, the situation has quite normalized. So we are able to do many things that we were doing in the past, not everything, but lots of things. And we are working hard organizing next semester and also organizing next year. So hopefully the situation will be back to normality and the pandemic will be over and we will be able to go back to our usual activities, our travels and our extracurricular activities, volunteer activities, internships, travels and so on and so forth. So I hope that you are studying hard, that you are preparing to come to Florence. The city is waiting for you. We are waiting for you. And please be in touch with me if you have any questions, any doubts, if I can help you. And again, I'm sorry I cannot be with you. But as I said, I would be very, very happy to welcome you in Florence and organize for you all the things that we have done in the past and even new things on which we are working. Internships, new opportunities, new courses, etc. So again, I hope to see you. Spero di vedervi a Firenze and please be in touch with me if you have any questions. I would be very happy to help you. Ciao, a presto!